Hello, everybody. We are joined by Gen G, who are coming off of their victory against Fnatic. We will begin with remote media with Strafe Esports.
This is for to coach Solo and the whole team. If they want to add up, in at least at Shanghai, it has been a pattern where you start a bit slow on the first maps, eventually close it out and get hotter as the series continues. Do you think that would eventually be a problem against much stronger teams?
팀에서 아무나 대답해 주시면 되는데 상하이에서 약간 젠지가 일정한 패턴을 보여주는 것 같아요. 첫 번째 맵에서 좀 서서히 예열을 하고 이제 다음부터 좀 웜업이 된 후에 승리를 거두는 패턴인데 약간 이런 패턴이 앞으로 더 강한 팀들을 만나게 될때좀 문제가 될 거라고 생각하시나요?
일단 저희가 첫 세트 때 그리고 초반에 무너지는 경우가 되게 많은데 사실 뭐 어느 정도 짐작은 하고 있지만 정확한 이유는 알수 없거든요. 그래서 뭐 1세트 저도 원래 하던 대로 나머지 이기면 되니까 그래서 신경 쓰지 말자 그런 생각을 하기도 있고, 그리고 상대 팀들이 봤을 때도 저희가 1세트 때 문제가 있다는 거로 생각하기 때문에 오히려 상대가 방심하지 않을까 생각하네요.
Well, yeah, we always struggle in the first map. For some reason, I can't quite pinpoint why, although we are close to, getting the exact reason why. But having that slow start, we know that we can win in the next map as usual because it's what we usually do. And I think it can make the opponents kind of let their guards down, and we can maybe catch the opponents off guard when we step into the second map all warmed up.
Thank you. Can I ask a follow-up question?
Yes.
Okay. This is to anyone who wants to answer. Your next opponent would be 100 Thieves, and they have been calling themselves one of the best teams out here. What are your thoughts on about facing them and how they look, especially after their win against FUT today? FUT today.
아무나 대답해 주시면 되는데 다음 상대가 백티잖아요. 이제 사람들이 최고의 팀중 하나다라고 평가를 하고 있고 오늘 또 풋 상대로 좋은 경기를 보여줬는데 다음에 만날 상대 백티에 대해서 어떻게 생각하시나요?
충분히 공연이 1등으로 올라왔으니까 아메리카에서 잘한다고 생각을 하고 있고, 저희도 아직 시간이 승리했기 때문에 시간이 있어서 충분히 잘 준비하면은 네. 마드리드 때처럼 올라가지 않을까. 네. 열심히 저희가 잘한다면 네. 그렇게 생각하고 있습니다.
Well, of course, they're here as America's number one seed, so no wonder they're a really good team. They're a strong team. But with this win, we get extra days to prep. So if we put in the work and try our best, I think we can make a great run like we did in Madrid.
Thank you so much. Congratulations on the win, and all the best for the next game.
Thank you. Good.
Thank you. We'll next go to Rabia from Jinx.
Hello everyone. Congratulations on the win today. It was a great game. I don't have a question about this match, but the next game is against 100 Thieves. It's like a follow-up question for the previous question. We know Boostio likes to talk a lot on stage and before the game as well. I want to know, do you guys have any message for 100 Thieves or specifically for Boostio?
보스티오 선수가 워낙 경기 전이랑 후에 트래시토크 하기를 좋아하잖아요. 도발하기를. 맥티나 보스티오 선수에게 하고 싶은 말이 있을까요?
그래서 뭐, 일단 저는 게임 외적으로 떠나서 이야기하고 싶은데, 보스티오 선수가 일어나면 굉장히 귀엽더라고요. 그래서 사실 저는 제가 상대팀에서 보스티오 선수가 일어난 걸 봤을 때 오히려 화가 나야 되는데 왜 이렇게 귀엽냐 하면서 비고 있어도 웃음을 만들어줄 것 같은 친구들. 그래서 사실 저 그게 트래시 토크라고 생각은 안 하고. 백티 잘하던데 재밌을 것 같아요, 저희도.
I want to talk about how he is outside of the server because when he stands up as a means of trash talk, he's rather cute, I have to admit. So when you're on the other side, when he stands up trying to kind of provoke you, it's not going to make us mad because he's so cute. It's just going to give us like a good energy, make us happy. because of his cuteness. And I don't think of that as a trash talk. And it's going to be a fun game against them. They're a good team.
Thank you so much, and good luck for it.
Thank you. We'll go next to Clutch Points.
I have a question to Texture. In their post-match interview a while ago, 100 Thieves mentioned that they have their eyes on you. Do you have any messages for 100 Thieves knowing that you have a target on your back for your upcoming match?
흑자 선수에게 드리는 질문인데 백티가 인터뷰에서 젠지를 지켜보고 있다, 견제하고 있다라고 얘기를 했는데 백티에게 하고 싶은 말이 있을까요?
딱히 없는데 그냥 많이 지켜보고 많이 느끼세요.
Not much I would like to say back to 100 Thieves, but I would say thank you for watching us and keep watching us, trying to learn a lot from us.
We'll go next to Sports Kita.
Yes, my question is for Karen. So Karen, you wanted to face Fnatic in the playoffs and you got your wish. So did the matchup live up to your expectations and how was the overall experience, especially after the win?
서론 선수에게 드리는 질문인데 Fnatic 만나보고 싶다고 했는데 이제 소원을 풀었잖아요. 근데 좀 오늘 경기 해보고 나서 기대 이상이었는지 아니면 기대치에 어떤 얼만큼 미쳤는지 그리고 어떤 경험이었는지 궁금합니다.
일단 제 생각보다 기대 이상이었고요. 저희 유럽 가서도 마드리드 때도 스크림을 한 적이 있는데 확실히 대회를 겪고 나니 보니까 확실히 저의 기대 이상으로 더 잘하는 팀이었습니다.
Well, they were beyond my expectation. We scrimmed them in Madrid when we were in Madrid, but you know, having played them in an international tournament on stage, they were really good. It was on obviously on honestly beyond my expectations.
Thank you. We'll go to Pedro next.
Hey guys, likewise, congrats on the victory over Fnatic. I want to direct this question over to Munchkin. I want to focus on the third and final map and how it was pretty much a back and forth affair. At one point, I believe Genji lost multiple eco rounds and stuff like that. How difficult was it for you to kind of fend off Fnatic in that third and final map? And what kind of made the difference for you guys to eventually come out on top?
원지균 선수에게 드리는 질문인데 이제 브리즈에서 2코 라운드도 많이 내주고 좀 많이 어려웠을 것 같은데 어떻게 이렇게 역전을 해냈는지 그리고 역전을 하는 중에 어떤 점이 가장 어려웠는지 궁금합니다.
일단 2코 라운드는 브리즈만 그런 게 아니고 전체적으로 많이 따였고요. 그래서 2코 라운드 때 조심하자 조심하자 했는데 상대가 2코 라운드 때 더 잘하더라고요. 그래서 내줬고 3세트 때는 지고 있는 상황이었지만 설마 우리가 이렇게 쉽게 질까? 라는 생각을 하면서 그냥 생각 없이 그냥 계속 상대 것만 생각하면서 콜링하면서 이겼던 것 같아요.
Well, it wasn't just the breeze. It was just we were losing ecos all across the series today. So when it came to those eco rounds, I was telling myself and my teammates, you know, we need to do better and we need to watch out to make sure that we don't drop those rounds. But even when we were behind and playing from the deficit, I felt like there's no way we're dropping the series this easily. And I just focused on what they were doing, trying to get a good read and also try to give good calls for my teammates. And I'm just so glad that this comeback was possible.
Thank you. We'll go to Sons of Chaos.
Hello, everyone. Congratulations for the victory in this tight match. My question is for the coach Solo. For you, which were the key points or moments that decide the map in your favor?
솔로 감독님께 드리는 질문인데요. 오늘 승리를 갈랐던 승리 요인은 뭐라고 생각하시나요?
저희가 사실 로터스를 자신 있어 했고 이길 수 있다고 생각했었는데 저희가 좀 커뮤니케이션 미스가 좀 많이 나면서 무너졌는데 바인드를 상대방이 골랐잖아요. 그러니까 상대방이 저희가 바인드를 뭐 상대방이 잘해서 골랐거나 아니면 저희가 못한다고 생각해서 골랐었을 텐데 저희는 바인드에 진짜 너무 자신이 있었기 때문에 바인드를 이겨서 네 나머지 맵도 이겼다고 생각하고 있습니다. 네.
Well, I want to talk about Lotus first because we picked it because I thought, well, we thought we were very confident in that map and that it was winnable for us. But there were a lot of communication issues and like mistakes happening. But I feel like when Fnatic picked Bind, it was either they wanted to play into their strength or they wanted to tailor the map pick into, you know, what we're weak at, what we're not good at. But when it comes to Bind, we're feeling pretty confident. So I think it all came down to us stealing Bind from them that allowed us to eventually win the series.
Thank you and good luck in the next match.
Thank you. And Rabia, you will have the last remote question.
Hello again. I want to talk about Viper here. She underwent a huge nerf recently, and you were expecting that her usage will be, you know, affected badly in, you know, the international events, this Masters. But you've seen teams picking her up basically equally. I want to ask, is there any problem that you guys are facing in general while trying to play her, or is it like just the same?
아무나 대답을 해주시면 되는데 바이퍼에 대해서 물어보고 싶은데 최근에 너프를 먹으면서 좀 이 요원이 다르게 쓰이거나 또 마스터즈 상하이 들어오면서 좀 그 픽률에 영향을 많이 받을 거라고 예상이 됐었는데 많은 팀들이 그대로 바이퍼를 많이 기용하고 있잖아요. 젠지의 입장에서 좀 이 바이퍼가 너프된 바이퍼를 기용하는 데 있어서 좀 어려운 점이 있는지 아니면 예전이랑 똑같은 것 같은지 궁금합니다.
일단 바이퍼를 저희 팀이 굉장히 많이 쓴다고 생각해서 뭐 저희도 처음 이 너프 방안을 들었을 때 바이퍼에 대한 얘기를 되게 많이 했었거든요. 근데 일단 스크림만 해보면서 느낀 거는 좀 더 스킬에 대한 유전도 그 유전도 맞나? 아무튼 그게
의존도가
낮아진 거지. 사실 저 같은 경우는 좀 더 유틸 신경 안 쓰고 총 쏠 수 있어가지고 저는 더 마음에 들어요 오히려.
So we run Viper a lot. So when we heard about the nerfs, we had a lot of discussions when it came to running this agent. But when we scrimmed with Viper post nerf, it was just she was less reliant on the utils, and that was that. And that kind of enabled me to focus on my aim and shoot more, care less about the utils. So I think I like her post nerf than before nerf.
Great. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Are there any questions in the room? Go ahead.
Hi. Congrats on the win. So I wanted to know that about the first map and the last two maps, right? It seems like Fnatic had a much better control in a smaller map like Lotus, and then it seems like you guys were just dominating and just controlling them all over the place when it came to Bind and also Breeze. Is there any reasoning behind this?
아무나 대답해 주시면 되는데 뭔가 전체적으로 봤을 때 Fnatic이 좀 그 규모가 작은 맵들, 좁은 맵들을 좀 더 잘하고 젠지가 좀 넓은 맵들을 더 잘한다고 느끼신다고 하거든요. 특별한 이유가 있을까요?
딱히 그런 차이는 아니라고 생각하고요. 사실 저희는 저희의 컨디션이 가장 중요하기 때문에 저희가 뭐 1세대 때 컨디션이 안 좋아서 지면 지는 거고 뭐 2, 3세대 컨디션이 좋으면 이기는 거라고 생각을 해서 뭐 사실 맵 크기에 대한 의존은
I don't think it really just comes down to the range of the map. It's more on how we're feeling on that map. So if we're feeling kind of down in the first map, then we drop it. But if we're feeling better or if we're feeling good on other maps, then we take it. Thank you.
Thank you. This will conclude the press conference. Gen.G, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.